Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Prerna Kadoch, and I am a forensic science graduate. And right now, I am doing my master's in forensic science from Delhi University. My topic of e-poster is determination of range and direction of firing. So starting with the definition of range, the distance between the point of departure and point of explosion of bullet is range of fire. Basically, there are four range of shooting: contact range, close shot, near shot, and distance shot. We determine range of firing by following terms: burning, blackening, and tattooing. I'm giving you a few examples. In case of contact shot, burning, blackening, and tattooing, everything is present. Here is the question: how we differentiate between these terms? So let me introduce these terms to you. Burning is also called scorching, and it is the effect of flames or hot gases produced in combustion of propellants. This is caused when shot is fired from very close range. Blackening is also called smudging, and it is the carbonaceous deposition of skin. It is easily wiped off. Basically, it is caused by smoke deposits. Blackening is limited to a very, very short range. However, tattooing is also known as peppering, and it is the deposit of semi-burnt, or we can say unburnt, powder particles under skin, and it can't be removed easily. So with the help of these three terms, we can tell whether the range is contact shot, close shot, near shot, or distance shot. Just in case of close shot, burning, blackening, and tattooing is present, and same happen in contact shot. But the difference is that in contact shot, we also found muzzle pattern of weapon. In near shot, victim is within the range of tattooing, but out from the range of burning. In distance shot, victim is beyond the range of both tattooing and burning. We can say that everything is absent in distance shot. So this is how we can determine range of firing by seeing burning, blackening, and tattooing on entrance wound. Here's the next thing: that what about direction of firing? So for direction of firing, we consider both entrance as well as exit wound. Let's take the case of rifle firearm injury. In this case, abrasion collar plays the major role. Abrasion collar is formed on the skin of victim. And if I can use simple language, if the direction of firing is straight, then it is made in the center and GSR found around it. But if the direction of firing is upward, or we can say is slant, then it is made on lower side of center and GSR found on lower side of abrasion collar. Another case is, if I use mathematical terms, if the entry of bullet is 90 degree, then the shape of abrasion is round. If the entry is 45 degree, then the shape of abrasion is oval. So this is how we can estimate about direction of firing. And grease collar also tells about the direction of firing. Now I'm discussing Now I'm going to discuss a case from a muzzle entry of wound. And this was happened before 31st January 2017. Actually, this is the date of receiving. I don't have the exact date of this case. So this is the case of rifleman working in battalion was assigned with duty, and all of a sudden firing sound was heard. On verification, it was found that the rifleman had committed suicide with his surface rifle, having bullet wounds, one on backside situated in occipital bone and the other one over his forehead. At first, as per autopsy report, the entry wound was on backside and exit wound was on forehead. On close observation of photograph of entry wound caused by contact firing, it was seen that the wound area was lack of blackening, tattooing, and charring, also the absence of muzzle impression. The possibility of having entry wound on backside was rare. It was seen that the bullet injury is devastating and could cause when firing was made at contact of hard skull. The skull being hard could not expand due to inadequate space for expansion of gas. As a result, large quantities of gas entering into the skull rebound back and escaped through entry wound. It was found that one bullet mark was present at acute angle with respect to sitting position of security personnel. The position of bullet mark just after incident was suggestive of muzzle end of rifle in upward direction. So the conclusion is, on the basis of this case study, we can say that on the basis of wound ballistic study and crime spot analysis also, the entry wound on the forehead and the exit wound in the occipital bone on the backside of disease have been established. And the recovery of fired cartridge case was fired from the service firearm used by the security personnel. So that's all. Thank you.